Hello and welcome back to Let's Play Silent Hunter 4 Unicorns of the Pacific with me, 1F Jeff, also known as the Ovarian Barbarian. That's my pirate name. And we are gonna go die today, pretty sure, because last time we did this. And that means we're cursed. If you ever do that good at anything, the next time you try, you're gonna fail. So, I don't think we've had any major tech upgrades, nothing really big's going on. It's, January 17th, 1942. As far as my crew management goes, I'm proud of my crew, they did a good job, but I am gonna tweak some things around. I'm gonna drag some of these guys out of here. I'm gonna have, this guy go over and be my assistant deck gunner. So, Mr. Albert L. Hill will have some backup. And I'm also gonna get, a few people to do dedicated, damage control. Not a full cohort of people, but I am gonna scoot some people around, see if I can find some people here that have, engineering skill that I can toss in there, like this fellow, and let's see here, you, anybody that's, any better have... No, there's no real point in having anybody better at that. I'm wondering why some of these guys that have, like, deck watch skill are in my forward torpedo room, but whatever. I guess they like it there. I'll move some of the guys that have gun skill. They seem to be good secondaries. Come on, come here. There you go. Thank you, Sean C. Clinton. We're gonna hire some new people. I want someone to be in charge of repair room, so I'd like someone that has leadership skill, and, repair as a secondary. Let's see here. Ah, here we go. Stan L. Bowl, 250 renown. You are now in charge of the damage control team. So we'll have these four be our dedicated damage control. That means I need to fill out deck watch, and after that, I think we'll be fine. So I'll put, let's see here, Herman N. Nelson. He's good at deck watch. He goes there. And Tom Hugh Bell. There we go. No, you wish. You wish you were that good, but no, you're there. Okay, so this one's full and good. Why is there a torpedo guy here? No, you're a torpedo man. What are you doing? Bro. There's gotta be someone in here who's not good at... Oh god. I didn't put the right guy there. That's not right. Okay, so I'm still missing two people from deck watch. I'll just get a couple of little... These guys don't cost anything, as far as renown goes. I'll find someone that's good at deck watch and toss them in there. If there is anyone, they're all good at guns and leadership, and here we go. Michael Edward P. Ambrooster. Congratulations, bro. And who is the next lucky winner? Who will it be? Is there anyone? Will it be anyone? Is there anyone at all? Anybody have any skill at looking out the fucking top of our submarine? Anybody gone to school for looking out at shit? No, we don't have any graduate. There we go, Benjamin Tribell. Congrats, bro. Alright, so deck watch is fully kitted, our forward torpedo room is upgraded, our rear torpedo room is downgraded, and our damage control exists. So the next thing we need to do, well, I think I already gave out my promotions to everybody that was available for promotion, and yeah, we gave out all of our medals. Next thing we need to do is refill our torpedoes, which is a pain in the ass, so I'm gonna do it off screen, because you have to go like this. And then like this. I'll show you why it's a pain in the ass. Maybe one of you guys will be able to suggest a better way to do it. But I hate it, because once you've got... Like, I don't want to use these Mark 10s, because they're horrible. They're really bad. They are not good. And once you get these easy ones off the screen, you'll see that you got, like, this little scroll bar here, and you can scroll down and select more. Dang it, give it to me. Once you got the easy ones off the screen, then you have to scroll down, and it doesn't remember your place. So I'll scroll down to here, and I'll drag this torpedo over, and then we're back at the top, and I have to scroll down again. So I've almost done, but anyway, I'm going to off-screen the rest of it, because I'm a nice guy. Okay, our submarine, like me, is now completely full of crap. So, things have changed in the Pacific. We've lost Manila and the naval base Cavite that we were based at, and so now we're going to have to be... We're currently in Surabaya, Java, and we're going to be conducting operations out of there. I want to check and make sure my difficulty settings are the same. Yeah. Okay, cool. I think the sound and everything's fine. We did get this medal last time, the Medal of Valor. And we sunk a whole bunch of ships. So we need to... What I'd like to do is have a bit less successful. I don't want to push my luck too much. I just want to kind of, like, survive for a minute. So, with that said, let's go die. January 17th, 1942. To me, USS Spearfish. Depart on February 7th, 1942. Okay, so that's... A bit of a change, and we're going to patrol the Java Sea and engage enemy shipping. You got it. So I'll be back after the loading screen. Okay, here we are, back on the USS Spearface, with Commander Creepyface staring at my ass already. Oh wow, you've gained some weight around the midsection there, buddy. Guess you had a couple too many burgers while we were at port, huh? But at least you grew your eyeballs back, that's always good. And cool hat, bro. Alright, so it looks like it's nighttime. Let's go ahead and head up to the deck. Oh, I guess I could take this door. Oh, that takes me to the gun. Oops. I don't want to be at the gun. Alright, so... Do you have eyeballs? I think you do have eyeballs this time. That's good to know. It's very pleasing to know that my deckman has eyeballs. So, I did a little looking around on some of the guides. I'm gonna go ahead and use this for my speed. Because about 10 knots is the most fuel efficient in heavy seas. So we'll hope that that works for me. To preserve some fuel. And this ought to get us to about the right speed. So let's head to the map room. And we've got a patrol order here. In the Java Sea. Which is filled with little tiny islands for us to crash into. Also, someone commented on the videos that... the way you complete these patrol missions is to stay within a 40-mile radius of the patrol order, so I'm going to do that for, I think he said 48 hours, something along those lines. So I'm going to go find the center here, and I'm going to mark out a 40-mile radius. If I can. Whoa. Of course, it's got that little thing in it. It's got that little spit of land for us to crash right into. Okay, so at this speed, it'll take us 28 hours to get to our patrol area. So we need to add another 48 to that. So we need to have about a 76-hour patrol. So let's map out a 76-hour patrol without crashing into that little island. We'll call it 80, just for funsies. There. Perfect. Okie dokie. We're off. Off to the races with the submarine car thing. I'll go ahead and... You guys can... Ooh. Don't want battle stations. Everything looks good here. I think we're ready to go to work. Let me make sure... Yep, we're all set. So I'll be back when something happens. Alright, so... We're quite a ways into our patrol here, and we've just got a contact on our sound hydrophones, or sonar, or whatever. And he's going away from us, so we'll let him go. We had one update here, but it was way out of our patrol area. We were over here at the time. So, again, just let him go. We're here to patrol, not sink. If they wanted us to sink, they'd tell us to sink. Or, that doesn't sound right. Hey, there we go. Completed objective. So that looks like it works. So now we have a couple options here. I could head back into port and mission over. Objective completed. Wait, what? Whoa. Settle down. Oh my god, where? I don't see him. Can you show me? Where? Over there? What was the bearing? 344. So, somewhere over here? Yeah, look. Hey, I got the number right. Getting good at this old bearing thing. You guys are crazy. I don't know what you're talking about. must have been a while ago or an old thing. So anyway, we could go back into port and end the mission patrol right here. But I'm not gonna do as many objectives as I did the last time. I'm gonna go ahead and do at least the one more. So let's send our. No! No! Don't go to 435 feet, please. We're in really shallow water. Let's see how deep it is. It's this deep. Please don't follow my orders at all. Alright, I think tragedy averted there. I don't know what that was all about. But, yeah, what we're gonna do is send in our report and let them know we're done. Okay, intelligence has requested an update on the enemy presence in Bandar Seri Bagawan. Recon the area and, if possible, infiltrate the anchorage and photograph enemy ships encountered. Ooh, buddy. That's a fun one. Photo recon. Okay, so we got a photo recon. I think that's up... Yeah, it's up here in northern Borneo. So, I'm going to take the Celebes and Sulu Sea route, because I've got a lot of contacts up here. South China Sea is just... And they've all been enemy task force, enemy task force, enemy task force. So we're going to go this way, because we'll have a little bit of... I just want to double check. Because these islands, like... Little ones will just pop out of nowhere when you zoom in. And check and make sure... Like that one right there. No island, island. And if you hit that, you are dead. So... Gonna be real careful when plotting out a course in shallow waters. So yeah, we're gonna cruise up here to go around the crazy dangerous area. That's not, I guess that's not a good spot to plot my course to, is it? Anybody gonna pop out of nowhere? Anybody? Alright, looks like this is probably a safe route. So yeah, we'll go around the edge and we'll creep up the coastline here and try and sneak into Bandar Seri Bagawan through this little hidey hole here. Hopefully there won't be any submarine nets. Looks like the port is on the outside, so we'll mark that in. And looks like that's our course for now. Our mission, photo recon. Now, I want to practice a little bit. I think for photo recon, you use the observation scope, and there's a way to take a picture. What's that do? Here it is. Photographs the locked target you have spotted with either periscope, so it doesn't matter which one. Okay. So now I've practiced, I know how to photograph stuff. These seas are looking a little choppy. I guess we're already throttled back. Let's take it up to 7 knots. I don't know what the best speed would be here, but...
Yes, sir. Current speed.
We'll set it for that. Okay, and I'll be back. Okay, so we just crossed the Celebes Sea, and we're getting into the Sulu Sea, and we got some pack news. Looks like Singapore has surrendered to the Japanese. That's great news. Because Singapore is not very far away from Surabaya. And we probably will not be going back to Surabaya. We've also hit some rough seas, so I throttle down. I'm going to actually go a little further, because we're down to 88% fuel. And we can no longer count on Surabaya as a place to refuel. So yeah, we are in some rough seas right now. The weather's a bit heavy. Let me take a look outside. Oh no, I guess it's calmed down quite a bit. Alright, well we can get back up to somewhere between 9 and 10 knots. And carry on towards Bandar Seri Bagawan, where we will take a picture. Okay, we just got a sound contact of a warship. He is there. It looks like he's moving away. How far away is he? 11 nautical miles. Yeah, he's not. We pass. Ship's passing in the night. Good news. Okay, maybe he's passing back. Or this might be a new one. Got another warship on our... Whoa! That's two. Closing speed, medium, long range. Oh boy. Oh shit. They're coming right at me. They're only about 9 nautical miles away. Let's kick it up into high gear, shall we? And... Oh boy. I'm gonna move our course marker. If I can. about this way? Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy, oh boy. That guy's close. He's only 7 nautical miles away. Holy fucking crap. This is a task force. Okay, well, while we've got him, I'm gonna be a good boy and send a report in of these contacts. I don't know what heading they're on. I haven't plotted that yet. Oh great, I'm going right into them. Fantastic. I don't know... We're heading 20 knots, so we should be able to outrun them. So I'm gonna bank on that. If they start shooting, though, then we got problems. Yeah, we're heading out. We're outrunning them. But who knows when we'll meet them again. And I'm wasting fuel, so... Fuck. Go away! Alright, we've made it here to Bandar Seri. We're not in the bay yet. The seas are very rough, so we're down to 3 nautical miles per hour, or 3 kilometers. Knots? 3 knots! Oh boy. They're very rough seas. So I think what we're actually going to do is, it is 1 o'clock in the morning right now. We're going to scoot a little bit closer, and then we're going to wait until tomorrow night to go in to take our pretty pictures, okay? Sound good, everybody? Sounds good to me. Okay, so we're going to stop right about here. Whenever we get there, probably... I'm surprised we haven't found any kind of screen or escort yet. We're just going to sit here on the surface and wait. All we are is just a little sonar beacon right now. Okay, so it's about 3, 4 o'clock, 5 o'clock, 6 o'clock, there we go. Okay, so I want to come at it like this, because I want to be able to take a picture of whatever's there before we get over here. So let's go. That is way too fast. I'll head in at 4, and see what kind of defense... Oh, we got one. Alright, that's probably a screen... Yeah, it's a screen warship on a patrol outside of there. So he's going counterclockwise... In an oval... He's not going in any pattern at all. What the hell was he doing up here? Okay, well... Yeah, I guess he's just patrolling this whole area. Whoa. Now he's going in like a figure eight. Alright, so let's say he's got this whole area. That's his patrol area. So we could sneak in here, maybe. But that would be really pushing it. Looks like he might be alone. No, he went out of that area. We got it wrong. Oh, boy. He's not coming at me, is he? No, he's not. Yeah, I think he's alone. I think our only shot here, really, is to take him out so that we'll have enough time to take these pictures. So that's what we're going to plan to do, is to go in guns blazing. Hopefully he'll spot us on the sonar or hydrophones and come at us. I'm going to go ahead and rig for... battle stations. I'm not going to bother with silent running, because I want him to know where we are. I want him to head right at me. There we go. Come on. Come on, get me. Nope. Oh, shit, we're still on the surface.
Yes, sir.
That was really stupid of me. I thought I was at periscope depth. Hi. How you doing? I'm not here, promise.
I'm invisible.
I hope your deck watch guy has no eyeballs either. Don't know if he spotted me. He didn't. Unless he did. And... Oh. Oh boy. No, I don't think he spotted me. Otherwise he'd be coming right at me. No, he didn't spot me. Come on, I'm right here, buddy. Okay, that music usually means you've been spotted. But he's behaving awfully strange. I'm actually gonna turn into him. Okay. Probably spotted me. What's my range? 1.5 nautical miles. Straighten up. Okay, what are we looking at now? Almost within firing range. Okay. I'm right here, buddy. Come get me. I said come get me! Don't make me turn again. Alright, I'm gonna kick up the speed a bit. Hunting a destroyer is about the stupidest thing any sub-captain could ever do. Which is why it's up to me to do it. They didn't hire me to be smart. Oh boy. Okay, here we go. This is it. Oh boy, he's way closer than I thought. Oops. Nope, we're about good. Alright, let's get on a constant bearing. And let's open up 1, 2, 3, 4. I actually did it 1, 3, 4, 2, but whatever! We need to identify him quickly and sink him. Okay, stupid waves. Alright, he's not a Fuso battleship. Oh boy, he's real close. Alright, he's a destroyer, not a minesweeper. I don't know if that's a destroyer. That might not be a destroyer. This looks kind of like him. Large minesweeper. No. He's got 2 forward guns. Bottom one's a little smaller. This looks like him, a Fubuki. Maybe. Yeah, I think that's him. Alright, let's range him out. Lock it in. Bearing will be like this. Speed, give me a number, guys. Son of a bitch. What is that? Bearing's wrong. Yeah, he definitely knows we're here now. Alright, I'm gonna guess he's going about 12 knots. Targeting computer says... Fuck it, fire. Shit. Fire. Back emergency, crank it to the left. One of those has got to hit him. Come on, I need 2 hits. Oh boy, he's real close to us. Come on! Shit. Alright, we got him with 1. Hopefully that was a really good shot. Because if not, we are fucking dead. Hear him. Oh, there he is. Okay, let's raise up our scope. Alright, he missed us. We're gonna go... Actually, we are gonna back around. Let's go flank speed. And crank it to the left. Let's see if we can get him with a rear torpedo. He's not shooting at us because this is happening in the middle of the night. That ought to be good enough. Let's go back to standard... Straighten out. Lock it in. His new bearing is... something like this. Let's go to this one. Lock it. Track it. Range is... thither-ish. And... speed is 6. Fire. That's a bad guess. Plus, I had a tweak on it. High speed. Do this one by hand. Torpedo's a dud. Damn it. Alright. High speed. Looks like he might be turning into it a little bit, so let's go ahead and fire it. And 7. I hate destroyers. They're such a waste of torpedoes. I don't know. I'm going to go ahead and recalculate his bearing and information here. Let me just make sure I'm not muted. Good! Okay, looks like he's like that now. Okay, and range him again. Please, let me range him again. And you got his new speed for me? Lock it in and fire. Boom! Got him! Excellent. That is exactly what we needed. Alright, this one might miss. He may stop after this. Oh, whoa! We got him again? No, we must have hit the wall or something. Probably hit the seaport. Sorry about that. Sorry about your port, guys. What is that? I don't know what that is. That looks like a merchant ship. I'm not too concerned about that at the moment. Concerned about this fellow. Yeah, we must have missed him. It would have hit by now.